French, a banana, mother. We're at the best place around. Sound stupid with a flare gun. Burn the place to the ground. Smoke on the water. Fire in the sky. Smoke on the water.
Are you ready?
Ladies and gentlemen!
The way I see it, Barry, this should be a very dynamite show.
You know, I have no idea what the name of this program is, but you're watching it.
Backstage.
All you ever want.
Backstage.
All you ever need.
Backstage.
Your dreams will be fulfilled once you are there. You'll never want to leave. Sell your ass for that backstage pass.
Backstage
is just for the invited.
Backstage,
they laid on everything. Ba 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 ba. You don't believe. He doesn't believe.
I don't believe.
We are not here, right?
No.
Okay. So it's a complete illusion. So this is not Peter Freestone and I'm not Rudi Dolezal. We are aliens.
Well, no, it's just amazing what you can do with technology nowadays.
This is true.
You know,
I would be completely lost if not my son Ruby would sit on the other side and do all this.
Well, this is the thing. It's only young people who are able to do things like this. I can't.
But you're younger than me. You look so young. I don't know.
That's the makeup lady.
Yep, she's great. Yep.
She's a miracle worker.
Okay. Now, I forgot, of course, that to brief you on anything, but I'm telling you now, it's Sunday. Okay? It is Sunday. Just
so
believe
I'm back home.
You're Now, this is recorded, of course, but it's going to be shown on Sunday. That means we are more making a resume of what we've done here a little bit, and then you tell me to fuck off or something like that, like Freddie or
like normal.
So, first of all, thank you again for coming all the way. You took the strain with the train. Are we not really funny, guys? I mean, I know there must be a lot of people watching this and saying, well, there's no alcohol, there's no drugs. I let Peter talk, please.
No. Okay. What have I got to say?
Yeah, a lot. No, we have done, while we cannot tell you everything we've done, because some of it is, as always,
secrets.
But we can tell you that Peter was so kind to be part in my talk show on Krone TV, which is, of course, in English, and we'll get German subtitles.
Oh, you mean you won't have overdubbing so people don't hear me?
Are you crazy? I never overdub. And I'm thankfully, people at Krone TV are listening to me sometimes. And Even my old films with Frank Zappa and whatever in the 70s, I always used subtitles because it's so important to hear how somebody says something.
No, of course, of course.
I mean, honestly, this is now no BS, no backstage bullshit. Sorry for being obscene. But it's been a long day today, we can say that. Yes. So in the talk show, this is English with German subtitles. That means we will post when it's on air. And you go to krone.at, also the English-speaking queenies all around the world can view it and know what we're talking about. The other thing which I can tell you, and I'm very thankful, and this is not funny, this is a serious project, but an important project, is that I was asked by Austrian television, ORF, to do a big documentary, a different documentary on Corona COVID-19. Yeah. And we did an interview on that. Peter, of course, as you all know, or most of you know who watched this, is very active in the AIDS awareness, going to schools, doing very, very important work, which salute you. And
for me, this is the most important project. For me, it's the most important project that I will ever be involved in my life, because so many people know I care about the new generation. My generation is doing an amazing job at destroying this world. The new generation has new one has to just live with what we're going to give them. AIDS is around, it's not going to go away. And I just want young people to know, you as long as you know about something, you can take care of something. So with Milan Chetnik and I, we go around schools or anywhere in the world to make students aware of HIV and AIDS. You know, if you know about something, you can do something about it. And that's the whole point. And it's the same, in fact, now. I mean, just thinking about it, with this COVID business, it's not going to go away. You know, we're going to have to live with this. Mm. So we have to know how to deal with it.
First of all, that you do this because, I mean, remember when Freddie passed?
Yeah.
I don't know how you felt, but I was very, very angry also. There was, of course, the sadness and everything that somebody goes through. You probably much more because you were not closer. But I used this angriness or this to put it into a 3-year AIDS awareness campaign because I wanted to do something good. Mm-hmm. I said, you know, if anything comes out of this, I use this energy and this thing to make people aware, to inform, and to do things.
The way maybe it sounds strange to people, but the way I look at it is that, you know, 30 years later now, this year, Freddie is still teaching people, still telling people what to do, how to do things. He's around more now than he was for those last 5 years of his life. So many people I speak to, get messages from, they feel him. He's there. And with this project, with the TFA project, he is there in the schools. We talk from 13 years old upwards, because I don't want to upset any of you parents out there. But at 13 years old, I've seen what's on 13-year-olds' mobile phones. Mm-hmm. And it's a little bit more than they will admit to. Mm-hmm. So they know about things. So that's why we start at 13. If you know, you can do something.
And also the reason why you've seen phones is because you're teaching English. Part of it, and you say you're also, you know, you're teaching girls and boys who are about that age as well.
Yeah,
right?
I do English conversation for the school. I don't know I know in Europe, well, in most of Europe, it's maturita. It's the exam that they take at about 18, 19 years old. And I do English conversation with them for English. And we are able, it's amazing because we can talk about anything and everything. I suppose it's selfish, really, of me. I love working with these guys because I get so much energy out of them. You know, so it's selfish for me. I spend time with them because it makes me feel better. And as I say, they raise the topics. We talk about anything and everything. And so I do know what's going on. But as I say, the beginning of this little bit, that it's, for me, it's still Freddie that's there being part of everybody's life.
I mean, I especially now, of course, in those 2 days, and we've explained this for German television, Austrian television, etc. If the two of us talk, that also, you know, was this the basis of our new empowerment of our friendship, because we talk, yes, about different things, but also we can talk about Freddie in a way that only people who have been there can talk with each other and will understand, and it makes us happy. So I said,
because he's still with us then.
Yeah.
You know, anytime anybody speaks about him, you know, so many people just, you know, thank me for keeping Freddie alive, for, you know, talking about him, but, you know, it's because of me that he's around. It isn't. It's because of every single person out there who talks about him, who thinks about him. I'm just here to answer a question or two. That's it. That's all I do.
But it's a little bit more, but it's always nice that you are so decent. And it's a little bit similar when people say to me also on social media, oh, you're a legend. I said, no, Freddie was the legend. I'm
precisely,
just a filmmaker.
This is what I was just
directing the cameras, and he was the legend and the genius.
I mean, Freddie was and is always the star. You know, the image that I tell sometimes is that there was this huge Freddie Mercury, and I would hide behind his left calf. And then I would run out, I would do something and hide back behind them. Now, there's still this massive image of Freddie Mercury, but you can see through it a little bit more. So people actually see me behind his calf now, and they come and talk to me.
Very nice how you put that. You're becoming a real poet, you know that? No,
that's what lyrics are.
Yeah.
And I didn't know I could write lyrics.
Yeah, but you're also recording an album, right?
Yes. Yeah.
Oh my God, I'm already. I'm always. He's always a bad.
I keep things quiet.
Yes.
And someone can't keep his mouth shut.
Rudi. I'm sorry. No, because I'm apologizing. No, he will. It's your thing. But what I really, really enjoy with your company, and let me do this as a really big compliment to you as a person and as a great human being that you are, is your kindness and your openness. And yes, sometimes, very, very rarely, we talk a little bit louder because one of us is a little bit pissed off with something.
I'm sorry about that.
No, but honestly so. But mainly, it's practically impossible to do an argument or a fight with Mr. Freestone. Believe me, I'm somebody who gives very often maybe the one or the other thing, where Peter is always calm, is always thinking of what he's saying. I mean, at least how I see you, maybe in the Czech Republic when you're behind closed doors and your cat
shouting at myself.
And your cats could talk. Maybe that would be different. That is really something. And also what I really, really am thankful is that our friendship intensified.
Yes.
And I really can say that you are one of my best friends.
Thank you.
If not the best friend.
It means a lot.
Because remember when I was in America in the lockdown and you were in the Czech Republic, we talked almost every day.
Oh, yes. And you know? Only for about half an hour or something.
Or two hours. Sometimes. I mean, of course, WhatsApp or Facebook, so it didn't cost anything. Right? But you don't do this with somebody when you don't have anything to say.
No, precisely. This is the thing.
And you're caring about me, and I'm caring, I said, how did this go, and did that go? And that's what friendship is about.
I mean, the thing is, though, this, what I know, how long have we known each other? A year or two, since we were young
children. No. Let me answer this precisely. I came into the Queen world in a way that you would notice. I mean, mm-hmm. Paul Prenter was the first person, apart from the boys, as everybody told about the band, yeah. that I realized that. But he was not around a long time anymore then. We're talking 84, 85, 83, whatever. One Vision, friends will be friends.
Yeah.
Must have been the first time you and I saw each other physically.
Yeah.
If not, no. You know when we saw each other first? Remember, with One Vision, there was one reshoot in London.
Yes, when
they were singing the ha, 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 and Rudi wasn't able to film it in Munich.
Yeah.
And I rebuilt the corner of the Musicland studio. And afterwards, Freddie asked everybody, including my team and myself, into the apartment, into the flat.
Yeah.
Where was this again?
Stafford Terrace.
And you must have been there.
Yes. Yeah.
Physically.
Yeah.
And that means 85.
So 85, 95, 05.
15.
Nearly 50, 30. When we were children, 30, 35. We met.
No. And yeah, and then of course, yes.
What I was saying is the fact that, okay, we haven't spoken to each other every day for 30-odd years.
No.
But friends don't have to.
Cool.
You talk to a friend, and you talk on the phone, put the phone down, and you might, just through chance, not speak to them for about 6 months.
And then you
pick up the phone, and you talk, and the conversation just carries on.
Absolutely.
And that's friendship. And that's friends.
Absolutely. And the thing was that, remember, we our path, if I pronounce it correctly, as a paths crossed again when I invited you for this television show in Germany.
In Germany, yes.
Queen of the Show, also yeah. Jim Hutton.
Yes.
Where we made the discussion. And then, you know.
And there's this video pan of us looking up like this.
Although before that, I was visiting you for several interviews for Queen Productions in your when you were renting
I was in the hotel.
The hotel.
Was that one.
Yeah.
I mean, the first one was in 1992, though, wasn't it? 1992.
Yes, well, the very first one was right after Freddie died, the documentary, which was never released, where everybody started crying after 10 minutes. You remember that one?
Yeah.
Including I stopped the film because it was too close.
Yeah.
And after I don't know, 20 minutes, either the person I interviewed or myself, we started crying. Yeah. And I said to Jim, we can't have a film where everybody just cries all the time, although there is people crying or making you cry in my documentaries, but one or two on exactly the point where it's legitimate. Anyway, but then of course the untold story, and I will never forget. I don't know Magic Years. You were in Magic Years as well, which was 86.
But you see, this is the strange thing is because, you know, normally, if you finish a job, it's the end of a chapter in your life.
Mm-hmm.
You turn the page and start anew, mm-hmm. and I was never given that chance. I'm not complaining, don't get me wrong. I'm not saying anything against it. But I was never able to leave Freddie out of my life because I was constantly asked, Can you do this interview? Can you do this? Can you do? I mean, I'm. Don't get me wrong. I'm incredibly grateful for it because of what it's. Everything has led up. I mean, for me, as far as I'm concerned, everything's led up to this TFA project.
The TFA project is the AIDS awareness project. For those of you who are not familiar with the short version,
for the schools.
For the schools.
I mean, okay. Going back to that, we have actually spoken to over 16,000 students around the world.
Great.
Because part of the deal is, if I have to go somewhere to do something, they have to arrange meetings in schools.
Oh, very good. Very well so. Yeah.
So because of that, I was never really able to close that chapter.
Would you have liked to?
No. I think back then, it wouldn't have been a problem. I couldn't do it now. Mm. Because too many people still, I don't want to say the wrong words, too many people rely on me to be still giving them something, to give them some hope, to give them something.
But see, that's, for example, the thing that I found out when I started social media and you were warning me. You were saying, Rudi, there will come a time where you will hate it. Yes, and it came, but I'm still doing it and I still have more positive than negative.
Me too.
Yeah, you too. No, very active. So, but thing was that I found out that people who have been with Freddie intensively, like you had, even more so, but I also had the chance in a different way. They are very precious to the queenies, to the queen world, to the people who want to know something. Yeah. Because the queen fans have the feeling, okay, they know what they're talking about because they've been there.
Yes. No, this is the thing. Also, I know so many of the queen fans. I've met them over the years. And some of them are the most wonderful people on earth, and I would do anything for them. Mm. I mean, they know who they are. It's wonderful when there is something that can bring total strangers together.
Mm. Absolutely. I know what you mean.
Because of that, of course, I'm not unhappy that I wasn't allowed to close that chapter. It will be open, that chapter's open till the day I die. Mm-hmm. Freddie was a massive, well, think about it, he was one third of my life at the time. Mm-hmm. I was 24 when I started, I was 36 when it finished. That's one third of my life. Mm-hmm. But since then, there's been another 30 years added on. But I love every minute. Mm-hmm. As I say, talking and making real friends out of the Queen fans. That's so important for me.
I mean, that's the thing that I'm missing, but it will happen because once I was invited to all the... I mean, I was there at the very first Queen convention with Jackie. When the very first one happened, I was filming it for Magic Years. But other than that, I was not really part of the Queen world for many years. And now I was invited to Breakthrough and to Montreux. And then because of the pandemic, this was canceled, that was canceled, But there will be the moment, and I'm looking forward to that. I also have to say that I will do this tour and go at least once through the most important ones, like Breakthrough of Montreux, or I was, you know, there was talks about Paris or Australia. Yeah. Let's see, yeah?
Because did you hear the news today?
No.
The Montreux birthday party will not happen.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah. Statement was released today.
No, I didn't know that. That's news. Well.
Well, the thing is, I mean, we're already going towards the end of April. Mm. You cannot organize. People can't book tickets and then get told a week before, no, we're not doing it. Mm-hmm. It's so sad because it's 75 years. It's his 75th birthday. But I know people are going to still celebrate, which is the main thing. And people have to do it the way they feel comfortable, the way they're happy.
Yeah, maybe I should postpone the release of my book. I didn't know that. I was actually hoping on Montreux.
Yeah,
because so many people. I mean, I was there when the statue was opened, as you know, I was privileged to film the lady who actually designed it, etc. Yeah. Czech origin, but living in London.
Irene,
exactly, who left us, but in a very high age. And now can ask Freddie whether or not he likes the statue. You know?
I will never get over looking at it thinking, she thought he was a bit bigger than real life. Because I was always told it was, you know, a life-size statue.
Yeah.
But it must be at least 1.5 times.
This is true. But, I mean, we have to get through this. We both have been tested negative, of course, today. We're always wearing this all the time. We just
outside.
Even outside. But the thing is that we have to get through this. Okay, well, no motor, good.
It was just, I saw on my spare minute or two, saw on Instagram.
Well, with we don't say how many interviews we did together, but it's
mounting up, and it's not finished.
Well,
but the thing is, it's nice to get it all done. Yeah. It's nice to get, you know, if I have to go somewhere.
You said to me, Rudi, organize something so I don't come for only one
thing.
Yes, precisely. Well, that's what I did, and now you're complaining.
Who's complaining?
You're complaining.
When?
Now.
I said it's good.
Okay.
Look, you. Do you want me to start speaking German then?
Yes, please. Immediately. Well, he did that to me. He really physically did that to me. Do you know what that means? That means fuck off. I have to say this on a Sunday.
I didn't say a word.
Yeah, but you see, by the way, we are acting like a married couple sometimes. Yeah, that's we don't really mean the mean things that we. Oh, you do? Oh my God!
Well, I was told don't waste time talking rubbish. Oh my God!
I thought you really liked me. Now I'm depressed. Honestly, this is probably the last backstage ever. I'm probably gonna stop this. This is.
All right, so you tell me how to do it and I'll take it over.
Okay, good. Okay.
Hello, how are you?
No, go on, it's your show now. No. Oh my God. If the two of us are together, you never know what happens.
It's crazy.
But there's one thing I want to say, which is the fascinating thing about some of the secret things that we cannot tell you. But anyway, that very often it goes like this in what he knows and what I know about days of the life of Freddie Mercury. Yeah. Like, you know, you getting up and, you know, making him ready, bringing him the cup of tea at 9 in the morning, like you always did. Getting him to the studio, Rudi taking over, filming a video, and although you were there, blah, blah, blah.
Give him back. And I take him home.
And you could say, how was it, you know? And you would know that. I wouldn't know that because I was still rapping in the studio. Yeah. So it's a nice mosaic. One day, maybe we should do a mosaic thing. Yeah.
One day.
Darlings, is there anything you want to say to my followers and friends around the world? Apart from the fact that you tell me to fuck off, of course. Yeah, that's what Freddie said sometimes. Here is the autograph and now fuck off. He was said it in a nice way, didn't he?
Yes.
Yeah, I remember more than once. Yeah.
No, thank you. That's what I want to say.
Thank you for
this evening, for now, for the last few days. It's been interesting. It's been good.
Thank you for coming. And we are not going to announce that we get married yet, but we love each other. No, thank you very much for watching. You know my three wishes. And at the end, please be so kind and pre-order my book if you haven't done it, or tell other people, it supports me. Please subscribe to the YouTube channel, Rudi Dolezal TV, and then now it says something strange. You have to be. It is Mr. Sunday, Rudi Backstage. And we love you, love and respect. Oh, what? Okay, now. Okay. It's over. No, it's not. It's over. No, it's not. Maybe it's over. Okay. Marcel, this is an old one. Backstage of...
But this is when we're married.
Yes, exactly. You can show this. They're really going to believe you're going to marry. Okay, we have to stop. They have to do something tomorrow. Darlings, until this day, Freddie is the person in all my life that influenced me the most. My mentor, my hero, my friend. This book tells it all. Easy love, but you got friends, you can trust. Friends will be friends when you're in need of love, they give you care and attention. Friends will be friends when you're through with life, but not hope. Freddie was a special person, and I felt very privileged to call him my friend and to work with him and Queen. This book tells it all.
You wanna know what goes on backstage? Oh, come on. Let me take you by the hand. Ow!
Rudi, are you ready?
Ladies and gentlemen!
The way I see it, Barry, this should be a very dynamite show.
You know, I have no idea what the name of this program is, but you're watching it.
Backstage.
All you ever want.
Backstage.
All you ever need.
Backstage.
Your dreams will be fulfilled once you are there. You'll never wanna leave. You'll wanna sell your ass for that backstage pass.
Backstage.
It's just for the invited.
Backstage.